Today, we're going to set up an amateur radio satellite communication station. I'm going to walk through setting up an amateur radio satellite communication station, which is built around this used Icom model IC-910 VHF UHF transceiver, a CSN Technologies self-contained antenna tracking unit, a Yeasu G-5500 antenna rotator and controlling unit, and a pair of M2 low Earth orbit satellite antennas. It's a great setup. It's fairly straightforward. So I just purchased this S.A.T. This is the latest version. It comes with the module, the controlling module itself, a stand, a cable for connecting to the Yeasu G-5500 antenna rotator, a USB power cord, and the CIV cable, which is basically just a standard audio connecting cable. So take just a second to talk a little bit about the self-contained antenna tracker, the S.A.T. from CSN Technology. Great little device. There's a lot packed into this box. It has satellite tracking software built into it. It will control your rig. It will control the antenna rotator, and it even has a logging feature built into it. So there's a lot in this box, and it's a really great addition to a satellite communications station. This is my second satellite station. I have another one that's already built around a 9700, an IC9700, great radio that's really designed for satellite use. But this one's going to my alternate QTH in the Philippines, and so I just bought a used radio, and we'll build this station around the IC910. Well, that's a quick rundown of the major components of an amateur radio satellite station. But before we move on to setup, if you're getting anything out of this video or any of my videos, please subscribe and smash that like button. Now on to setup. We'll power up the S.A.T. So we open up the Wi-Fi settings. We need to find the S.A.T. item. And it just pops up here on the bottom, so let's click on it. We're now connected to it. We open up our browser. So on the S.A.T., the face of the S.A.T., it's showing us an IP address. So we just enter that in and we go to it. Now what we have to do is configure, we scroll to the bottom and we have to configure the network so that we'll automatically connect to the network. And my browser is the Iris. So I'll go ahead and enter in my Wi-Fi password. And connect. We go back to the IP address that it's showing on the screen, on the face of the S.A.T. And now we're into the S.A.T. and we're ready to go. So the first thing that I do is check for the update, and already tells us that there's an update available. So I will go ahead and do that. And when it's done, it restarts itself and it connects to the network. So the IP address it gives us is the same as the one we just used. So we reopen it, and there we go. We're up to the latest in the latest update for the S.A.T. Come down to the TLEs, the two-line elements. Let's go ahead and update those too, so we have the latest satellite files in the memory here. And it gives us 181 satellites loaded. And so now we're updated and we're configured for my Wi-Fi network. And let's look at setting up the radio and the rotator. Connecting the S.A.T. to the radio couldn't be simpler. It's just simply a regular audio style patch cable. We connect it in to the radio jack on the S.A.T. and then on the back of the 910, the IC-910, it's the CIV plug, and you just plug it in. And that's the connections. Before we configure the SAT any further, we want to check a couple of settings here in the radio. We power it on, push the set button, hold it down, and we want to, you can scroll through the menu here, but you want to scroll through to the CIV baud rate. 19200 is what we're looking for. And the other setting is your CIV address, the hex address, and for us it's 60H. The H is invisible, but it's there. So those are the two settings you have to remember when we're configuring the SAT. We power up the SAT, and then I log into it with my laptop. So we've come back into the SAT page, which is now linked to the SAT with the IP address that was on the front of it. Before we do much further configuration, let's go to location. Enter your call sign, your grid square. If you have a good satellite connection, if you got enough satellites, if you use GPS, it will enter the data for you, which is very convenient. Otherwise, you can enter that information in independently, manually. Click save. And then we want to come down to the radio. And on at the top here, the type, these are the radios you have to, the options you have to select from. In our case, we want the 910, which is the same as the 820 or the 821. Here's the baud rate that we just confirmed in the radio, 19200. And the CIV address is 60H. So we've done that, and let's save the radio settings and test it out on the radio. If you want to take a look at all the satellites that were, you know, eligible for us to track, go to all satellites, and here's the list. Now, to populate your favorites, just check them here. I've already done that. We've got all the Tevel satellites in there, and we're ready to go. And then to find the next passes, we click on next passes. And there we are with the Tevel 3. It's going to be a 77.45 degree maximum elevation, which is a beautiful pass. And that's coming up in just a few minutes. So to find the satellite, you can either enter the name in here and do a search, or you can go to the next passes and click on that satellite, and it will bring up the Tevel 3 satellite. On the right-hand side is the information about the satellite. Keep an eye on these blocks down here. Sometimes it's not on the mode that you want. We want the VU mode, which is VHF up and UHF down. It's in FM, and it will adjust the radio frequencies for Doppler shift once the satellite gets close. At the top of the screen, there's three little charts here. The one on the left is the map with the overflight path of the satellite. The graph in the center, the chart in the center, shows you how it's going to pass over your location. The idea being you're in the center of this graph. And The chart on the right shows the progress of the satellite as it's passing over. When you look at the radio, you see the submenu icon blinking on the screen, which tells you that this is connected, and it's switching back and forth between the radio and the controller. If you watch the screen of the radio, you can see the SAT controller changing the frequency. As the satellite gets closer, it's changing more rapidly. Configuration of the satellite rotator is nearly as simple as hooking up the rig. Simply insert the cable, the rotator cable, into the top on one side, and the other end just plugs into the back of the G5500 rotator controller module. To calibrate the rotator, we come down on the screen. We've entered the SAT online here. We click on rotator. Now that we're on the rotator page, we come to the top, and under type, we select our rotator. It's a G5500 is my rotator. It's the standard. And we come down and we select volts, which is displayed here. And this is with the antenna parked at 0 degrees elevation and 0 degrees azimuth. And you can do an auto calibration. Just click the auto calibration button and it will run the rotator to its endpoints and automatically calibrate. But I'm going to walk through the manual calibration. To do that, I go to the Yeasu G5500 controller and I manually run the rotator to its endpoints, both azimuth and elevation. Anyway, so we manually run the rotator to its endpoints. We're at 180 degrees right now in elevation. All right, it's at its endpoint for the azimuth as well. So now we're at the endpoint for both azimuth and elevation. And neither of them is above 5 volts, so we're good. And at this point, we set max. That sets the maximum voltage to show the SAT where the endpoint is. And now we just reverse it back to 0 degrees elevation to and 0 degrees azimuth, its starting point. All right, we're back to 0 degrees azimuth and 0 degrees elevation, which is our original starting point. And so we now set minimum. And now the SAT knows the starting point and the end point for the rotator.
Well, now that we have the rig connected and the rotator calibrated, let's make some contacts.
CQ, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform.
Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, Alpha Alpha 1 X-ray Papa.
Alpha Alpha 1 X-ray Papa, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform. Echo Lima 8-9, name here is Jeff, I'm in Central Florida, about 10 miles from the Gulf Coast, over.
Roger, roger, well, you got the nicer weather down here, although it's not too bad up here in Connecticut. I'm Fox November 3-1, Chuck.
Roger on the Fox November 3-1, and negative on the good weather. It's like 52 degrees here. I'm freezing my tail off. Unusual for Florida, but they say it's El Nino this year. It was predicted. Over.
Good morning, guys. KB2M.
KB2M, WKA for you.
Good morning. We're on our EL-99.
How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing all right. We got 40 degrees right now.
Holy cow, you're worse than Jeff over there, isn't Jeff?
Yeah, it's, I think, 52 degrees is what it was saying here on my phone app. I'm up in up near Crystal River, between Crystal River and Ocala.
Yeah, I'm down here in Palm Coast, just about 20 miles above Daytona.
Good morning, WA4HF is Echo Mary 55.
Hey, good morning, NKB2M, the L99.
Roger. I'm
sorry.
Yeah, 37 degrees in Memphis, rather cold.
X-ray Echo 1 Yankee Delta Kilo, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform.
SQL, SQL. Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, X-ray Echo 1 Yankee Delta Kilo, SQL.
Roger, roger, Echo Lima 8-9, over.
SQL, SQL, thank you, 73, Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, X-ray Echo 1 Yankee Delta Kilo.
X-ray Echo 1 Yankee Delta Kilo, Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, 73. NHURE, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, Echo Lima 8-9.
Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, NHURE,
Fox 1. Roger, 73s, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Kilo Oscar 4, Papa Delta India, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, you're 5-9 and Echo Lima 8-9.
Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, God's in the book, thanks a lot, man, Happy New Year.
73, Happy New Year.
Whiskey K3 Uniform, N2YZH.
N2YZH, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform, Echo Lima 8-9.
N2YZH is FN22 QSL.
Roger, roger. Thanks much for the contact, 73.
73, appreciate it. Happy New Year.
58, Papa Uniform.
N2FYA, this is Whiskey Kilo 3 Uniform. Good to hear you again. 73's, Happy New Year.
Okay, 73.
Well, that's the basics of setting up an amateur radio satellite communication station. I glossed over a few areas. Of course, I couldn't touch on everything, but this should be enough to actually get you on the air in working the satellites. So best of luck. And thanks very much for watching the video. 73s.